Good morning to all of you. Welcome to Legal Matters by Sai Baba Sankara. Video number 1426, I believe. In this class, we are going to read a good judgment by the Honorable Supreme Court of India, that too, none other than Dr. D.Y. Chandrachud and A.S. Bopanna, to substantiate as to whether the admissions by the advocate can be taken by the court. Supreme Court said the admissions of the advocate or the client need not be taken by the court. Generally they are binding, but they need not be taken by the court also. How this theory has developed, let us discuss through a court law, a case law. Justice D.Y. Chandrachud and A.S. Bopanna, while dealing with a case pertaining to, this is ESIC case pertaining to DACP, that is Dynamic Assured Career Program, Dynamic Assured Career Program scheme. So this is contained in ESIC rules, but when it is found against to the ESIC Act, then definitely, even though the lawyer admitted, it cannot be taken into consideration. You can see the case as Employees State Insurance Corporation, that is ESIC, versus Union of India, in Civil Appeal Number 152/2022, dated 20th January 2022. You can see the citation in Live Law 2022 SC, page number 78. So basically this is a case relating to ESIC employees. So the case goes like this. The ESIC employees, they are respond number 3 to 25, they got themselves, or they were appointed as assistant professors in ESIC Medical College as well as Dental College in the year 2012-2009, and on different dates they joined as in 2012 or up to 2014 they joined as assistant professors. Right. Now under the DACP scheme, that is Dynamic Assured Career Program scheme, which was issued in the year 2015, so the doctors who had got 2 years of service as assistant professors, definitely they can be elevated to associate professors. So basing on these rules, they have approached the Central Administrative Tribunal. Actually, first they asked the ESIC, which they did not agree. They admitted they have filed a petition before the Central Administrative Tribunal, claiming their elevation or their promotion from the cadre of assistant professor to associate professor, right? But ESIC totally denied and vehemently argued that these rules apply to only doctors. So these people, the persons who are assistant professors, are they not doctors? Definitely they are doctors. Here the main interpretation you have to take is whether professional doctor or the so-called teaching profession doctor. So this difference has created them, or they have moved them from pillar to post. Now they have filed a petition before the Central Administrative Tribunal. So please remember, Central Administrative Tribunal clearly based on the arguments of the ESIC and held that the rules or regulations, they are not relevant to the so-called professors, because it is only relevant to the doctors. It is not the subject matter. But since these persons are also doctors, please consider. So this is the direction given to the ESIC by the Central Administrative Tribunal. So once again, ESIC has to challenge this before the Honorable High Court of Karnataka. Yes, Karnataka dismissed this petition filed by the ESIC, stated that since they were recruited before 2015, and the regulations, DACP says that once they complete 2 years, they have to be given promotion. That's all, you give promotion. So aggrieved by this, now the ESIC came before the Supreme Court. Now Supreme Court clearly stated that the ESIC regulations 2015 show that the person who joined as an assistant professor, he can be promoted as associate professor only after 5 years of their continuous service. Now the advocate has to agree. Previously, the advocate on behalf of the assistant professors only stated that 2 years, because of the rules 2015. Now he has to agree. So whether he agrees or not is a different thing. But since the rules are there for theory in the professorship, from becoming an assistant professor to associate professor is 5 years, definitely these regulations will stand, and the 2015 DACP scheme will not come in the way. Right, so definitely the orders of the High Court are correct, are wrong, and therefore once again the Honorable Supreme Court of India stated that they have to work for 5 years. Already now they are in the year 2021, and therefore 5 years they have completed, definitely they can be promoted as an associate professor. This is the judgment given by the Honorable Supreme Court of India. In this connection, the main point to be considered is, please remember, ESIC is a corporation, and ESIC Act 1948 says definitely in this there is an act where they can take, they can follow their own procedure. You have to remember that. So anyway, good judgment. Please read it and enrich your legal knowledge. Thank you very much.